This weekend marks the 10th anniversary of the infamous Todd Bertuzzi attack on Steve Moore, and this fall the civil suit will finally be heard in a courtroom. Bertuzzi was once one of the most beloved Canucks. March 8, 2004 changed a lot of that because, rightly or wrongly, he tried to defend one of his best friends and teammate, Marcus Naslund. Hockey's unspoken code is a whole other discussion regarding this incident, and we're near the 10-year mark. Chris Simpson looks back at what started the chaos in the first place.
Todd Bertuzzi after Steve Moore. Grabs his shoulder, having a little chat with him, grabs his sweater, gives him a whack, and piling on is Andre Nikolishin, and everybody's into it. Now we get a line brawl.
Oh, Steve Moore's hurt really bad.
And the Vancouver trainer comes on quickly, and they need more than just the trainers. They're calling for medical help for Steve Moore.
It's difficult to believe it's been 10 years since that night in Vancouver, March 8th, 2004. And maybe still more difficult to believe, the civil suit stemming from the incident, Steve Moore versus Bertuzzi and Orca Bay, the parent company of the Vancouver Canucks, has yet to go to trial. A new trial date has been set for September 8th in Toronto. But to fully appreciate where this case sits, we need to understand how we got here. While March 8th is the appointed anniversary date, the event that triggered Moore Bertuzzi, as it's become known, took place 3 weeks previous, February 16th, 2004.
And Moore just hit Naslund, and Brad May went after Moore, and Naslund's hurt.
Now look at Moore, he's going out of his way. There comes the elbow out to get Marcus Naslund.
That was a cheap shot by a young kid on a captain, leading scorer in the league, and we get no call. We get no call. I mean, that is ridiculous. How does that happen?
And the refs immediately were yelling it was a clean hit. They were telling the Canucks players to settle down. It was a clean hit, and there was no penalty, obviously, and the league, the NHL, said it was a clean hit, and I think Marcus Naslund said it was a clean hit, too.
Regardless, the table was being set for some vigilante justice. Through innuendo and veiled threats, and some not so veiled, the code was in play.
When you see the best player and your buddy go down like that, your reactions are pretty strong.
Hockey's a strange game, and sometimes the hype is more than the game, and something might happen, something might not.
The next game between Colorado and Vancouver came and went without incident, as the league office had issued warnings, setting the stage for March 8th in Vancouver. And when Moore and Matt Cook went toe-to-toe in the first period, the prevailing thought was that justice had been served, and it was back to business as usual. But the Canucks apparently thought otherwise.
Even after the fight, every time I was on the ice, I would have two or three players challenging me to fight. I had just been challenged to fight, you know, 1 second before by Sean Pronger, I think, and so it was just, like I said, it was just another shift of player after player challenging me to fight.
Todd Bertuzzi after Steve Moore. Grabs his shoulder, having a little chat with him, grabs his sweater, gives him a whack, and piling on is Andre Nikolishin, and everybody's into it. Now we get a line brawl.
Oh, Steve Moore's hurt really bad.
And the Vancouver trainer comes on quickly, and they need more than just the trainers. They're calling for medical help for Steve Moore. And the score settling has gone too far.
I was knocked unconscious. So, I don't have any memory of it at the time. For me, the experience began probably 15, 20 minutes after it when I woke up in a dressing room with the medical staff cutting off my equipment. So I was on a stretcher looking up at them and wondering what had happened.
What happened was the end of Moore's career. Three fractured neck vertebrae, multiple lacerations, and a concussion. It would be 5 months before he left hospital. And despite a tearful apology, Todd Bertuzzi would be suspended for the remainder of the season, which amounted to 20 games, including playoffs.
Steve, I just want to apologize for what happened out there. That I had no intention on hurting you. That I feel awful for what transpired.
The police also launched a criminal investigation which resulted in Bertuzzi pleading guilty to assault causing bodily harm after a plea bargain, and he was conditionally discharged with no criminal record. Which leads us to where we are today. A civil case with Moore having launched a multi-million dollar lawsuit against Bertuzzi and Orca Bay, the parent company of the Vancouver Canucks.
In a lot of ways it just seems like it was yesterday that I was playing, and then in other ways I feel like this has been going on for a long, long time. So it's a time for reflection when we come around on the anniversary of March 8th, but it's very hard to believe.